Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna alhamdulillahi ta'ala nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla la wa man yudlil fala hadiya la. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Last week in our class of fiqh from Umdat al-Fiqh, we began with Kitab al-Zakah, the book of Zakah. And just as a quick revision, inshaAllah ta'ala, we mentioned last week, before we enter into any chapter, the first thing we need to do is what? Define that particular thing. And every single chapter we do this, because we said, حُكْمَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ فَرْعٌ مِنْ تَصَوُّرِهِ. That given a ruling of something, or the rules or regulation of something, is only a what of it? It's only a branch of it. You need to first and foremost define that thing. So last week we defined a zakah. And this week, inshallah ta'ala, will be a proof for those who are taking notes last week, mashallah ta'ala. So last week we defined a zakah. And when we define things linguistically and scientifically, according to the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we said, az-zakatu lughatan. Az-zakah linguistically has a number of meanings. And we mentioned three of these meanings. Who could give me the three meanings of zakah one by one? Na'am. Increase, az-ziyada. Because the Arabs used to say, zakka zar'u, the vegetation or the plantation, yani zakka has increased. Secondly, barakallahu fiq, to praise al-madhu wa thina. And what is the proof of madhu wa thina that zakah is used for this meaning? Barakallahu fiq. Allah Ta'ala yaqul in Surah An-Najm, فَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنَ اتَّقَى. Do not praise or flatter yourself. Allah knows best those who fear Allah Azza wa Jal. And the last one, نعم, which means purification or purity. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. And indeed successful is the one that's purified it, meaning purified his soul. So the third meaning of zakah is purification, wa islah, and righteousness. So these are three meanings linguistically. What about the meaning according to the sharia of Allah Azza wa Jal? Because this meaning is what is going to determine how we understand every single thing after this. What is a zakah shara'an? What does it mean, shara'an, a zakah? Even if you tell me in English, it's fine. Yes. Sorry? A what from your wealth? La. Barakallahu fi. The first thing, حَقٌ وَاجِبٌ is an obligatory due. Na'am, an obligatory due. And when we say حَقٌ, and this, the reason this definition helps everything is, when you say حَقٌ wajib, it's a due which is obligatory. It's a due meaning there has to be a minimum specified amount, a nisab. Yes? حَقٌ wajib. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ فِيك فِي مَالٍ خَاسٍ, from a specific type of wealth. Meaning not every single wealth you pay zakat upon. So for example, your jewelry that you use for adorning yourselves, your household goods, your cars, and so on and so forth. Zakat is not due upon these things. So haqqun wajib, from a specific wealth, barakallahu fiq, lita'ifa khasa, from a specific group of people. Those eight, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. Na'am, thank you very much. Fi zamanin, khas, a specific time. He has to complete a specific time frame. So this is az-zakah shara'an. After that, we went on to the obligation of az-zakah. Is it wajib? Na'am. It's obligatory. What is the ruling of the one that withholds the zakah because it disputes the obligation of az-zakah? Kafir. What about the one that does so out of laziness, complacency, or being miserly? What's his hukum? They said there's two opinions of the scholars. And what are the two opinions? Barakallahu fiq. Some scholars hold opinion, he's a kafir, he's a disbelief, like Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah ta'ala, based on the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fa in tabu, if they also repent, meaning from shirk and kufr, وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَوْتَوُ الزَّكَاةَ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ. Only then are they your brothers. And the other ulama say no, it's a major sin. And the most authentic opinion is what? It's a major sin not to pay the zakah, so long as it doesn't dispute its obligation. After looking at the hukum of the one that doesn't pay a zakah, we're going to go back to the definition of zakah. We said there's difference of opinion amongst the scholars, because when we look at the condition of a zakah, nothing is mentioned there, like you look at other babs of fiqh, about aql, sanity, and what? Maturity. So the scholars are in difference in opinion. That is it obligatory for the orphan to pay zakah? And also, is it obligatory for the insane to pay the zakah? And what was the most authentic opinion? It is, because the definition of zakah is what? It's a due right from a due wealth. It's got nothing to do with what? The person. That's what Allah Ta'ala said, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً. Take from their wealth. It's got nothing to do with the person. So an orphan, when the father passes away, whatever wealth is left behind, the zakah is due upon it every single year. And that's why Umar radiallahu anhu used to say, trade or invest the wealth of the orphan. Otherwise, all of it will be eaten up by what? By the zakah. All of it will be eaten up by what? The zakah. So you should invest it in something like property, for example, because the only zakah you pay on property for rent is what? The rent, and not upon the investment of the property. After that, we looked at the conditions that make zakah obligatory. Who can remember those conditions? Number one, Islam, barakallahu fiqh. So zakah is not due from a what? A kafir. However, would he be called to account yawm al-qiyamah? Na'am. And what's the proof of this? Qalu. What's the proof of this? Aywa. Ma salakakum fi saqar. What made you land in the hellfire? What would the kuffar say? Lam nakun min al-musallin. We're not of those who prayed. And what is the proof that zakah, they be called to account for it? وَلَمْ نَكُنْ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. We didn't feed the poor. This is zakah. So though they're not, it's not wajib, they're called to account. So the first condition, al-Islam. The second condition, hur. It should be free. The third condition, nisab. The minimum specific amount must be there. The fourth condition, it has to possess it, complete possession of that money. So for example, rent. If somebody pays you 1 year in advance for the rent, right? So you got the minimum specified amount, for example. You don't pay the zakah because you've not possessed it yet, because the year is not completed upon that rent. Because the house could burn down, it could get destroyed. So it has to be fully possessed by you. And the last condition, hawl, the specified period. And we said the specified period is usually how long? 1 year. Except in these following things. We mentioned three things. Or five. We mentioned five things. Number one is ribhut tijara, profit from trade. The profit from trade, we said there's a principle which is hauluhu, haul aslihi. It is due when the initial investment is due. So if you invest £1,000 in something and you make a profit of, let's say, £10,000 5 months later. So let's say 2019, January, you invest £1,000. The zakah is due next year, January 2020. But if you look at the profit you made came 5 months later. Do you wait another year to pay the profit, or do you pay the profit when the initial investment is due? When the initial investment is due, even if your profit is 1 day old. This applies to profits, things you put out for sale. For example, if I invest in mobile phones and different things as business people do, I don't have to wait for a year to pass on the profit of the mobile phone, but I'll pay it when the initial investment is due. Likewise, it applies to what? Cattles, cows, camels, sheep. So a sheep, for example, for five camels, the zakah that's due upon it is one sheep. So if by next year you have 10 sheep, you pay 10 camels, you pay two sheep. It doesn't matter when those sheep came. When the Prophet would send the Sahaba to collect the zakah, they count the numbers, but they don't count the what? The ages. Jayyid? And something zakah is due upon it when it matures, such as grains and fruits. And some things immediately. So if you're mining and you find gold, you don't wait for a year. Immediately you find it. If it reaches the nisab, the zakah is due. And honey, likewise. So these are the exceptions, but usually it's every year. But for these things, as soon as they mature, the zakah is due upon it. So last week, we ended with this, right? So this week, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to look at قول المؤلف, the statement of the scholar or the author, رحمه ta'ala, in which he says that وَلَا زَكَى فِي شَيْءٍ مِذَلِكَ حَتَّى يَبْلُغُ نِصَابًا. There's no zakah until it reaches the minimum specified amount. We've said this already last week, but just a repetition. وَتَجِبُ فِي مَا زَادَ عَلَى النِّصَابِ بِحَسَبِهِ أو بِحِسَابِهِ إِلَّا السَّائِمَ فَلَا شَيْءٍ فِي أَوْقَاسِهَا. Today's class, inshallah ta'ala, is going to be a lot of mathematics. And we've got, mashallah ta'ala, a good math teacher here. It's going to help us. You know, the zakah issue is like algebra. Simple algebra. That with algebra, there's signs or symbols that denotes figures, inshallah ta'ala. So he's saying there's no zakah in anything, or there is zakah in anything that reaches nisab and any increase upon it. So for example, if the minimum specified amount is 1,000, anything over 1,000, you have to pay what on it? The zakah. Except when it comes to cattle. Anything that falls within the ranges, even if there's an increase, there's no what? Zakah. So for example, 5 camels, 1 sheep. The next level is 10 camels, 2 sheep. 15 camels, 3 sheep. So anything that falls within the ranges, even if it's increased, there's no zakah. So for example, if you have any number between 5 to 9, how many sheep? 1. Even there's an increase. So the increase upon anything, you pay the zakah, except when it comes to what? Cattle, camels, cows, sheep. So long as it's not gone to the next level. So even though there's an increase, you only pay what? 1. Jayid? Except for a sa'ima. So it said, except for sa'ima and that which falls in, awqasiha. And it's awqas. Awqas, try to memorize the terminology, is the jam', the plural of waqs. Al-waqs is these ranges when it comes to cattle. So he said, Bab al-Zakat al-Sa'imah. So the first thing we're going to look at today, inshallah ta'ala, where the mathematics are going to come in, is Zakat al-Sa'imah. The Zakat for al-Sa'imah. Al-Sa'imah, the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, Wahiya al-Ra'iyyah, is that which grazes. And grazes here, lil-ushub, that grazes from the earth, that is not being planted by another human being. Meaning, it grazes from grasses or whatever that just naturally grown upon the land that's not purposely planted. Jayid? So the author goes on to say, Wahiya al-Ra'iyya, that eats from the earth that's not been planted by who? By Adami. So he says, Wahiya thalatha anwa', and they are 3 types. The first, al-ibl. The first of it is al-ibl. What's al-ibit? The camel. Jayid? The camel. The second, cow. And the third is the sheep. So one of the conditions is, it has to be what? As-sa'ima. Meaning, it grazes from the earth. That's not been planted by Adami. And the author, he mentioned that it has to be, yani, from the earth. That's not been planted. But from the earth, that's not been planted, from the land that's not been planted by a human being, means most of the year or all of the year. Most of the year or the whole year. So if you have cattle, sheep, cows, camels that you feed on hay, for example, or herbage, for example, is there zakat upon it? No. Because that's hay. It's not eating from the earth or the land that's not been planted by anybody. Unless you put them out for what? For sale. Then you have to pay zakat for arud al-tijara, those things which are for sale. But otherwise, there's no zakat. If you keep for your own self, jayid, and you're feeding it from hay or anything else, or from that which you planted, there's no zakah. What if you feed it for a part of the year? 8 months of the year, it's not eating from the land. Is there zakah? No. It has to be for the whole year or most of the year. What if it eats from the land that's not been planted by any human being for 7 months? Is there zakah? Yes. Because anything over 6 months is most of the year. So if he grazes from the land over 6 months, there's what upon it? Zakah. So long as he's reached the what? The minimum level or specified amount for a zakah. So therefore, when it comes to a sa'ima, that which grazes from the land, specifically the first category, which is al-ibl, which is camels, there are 3 conditions. The first condition is sa'ima, he has to graze from the land that's not been planted by Adami for most of the year. The second condition, he has to reach the minimum specified amount. And the third condition is that this camel should be used for breeding, for milk, and not for transportation or carrying goods. If it's used specifically for carrying goods or for transportation, there's not what due on it, no zakah. Jayid? So these are the conditions for a sa'ima min al-ibl. Conditions for sa'ima min al-ibl. So the author says, concerning the sa'ima min al-ibl, he says that وَلَا شَيْ فِي حَتَّى تَبْلُغُ خَمْسًا فَيَجُبُ فِيهَا شَاتٍ. There's no zakah upon the camel until it reaches five. Once it reaches five, zakah is obligatory. So if you have two camels, three camels, four camels, nothing. Once it reaches five, shat. فِي الْعَشْرِ. When it reaches 10 camels, two sheeps. وَفِي خَمْسَةَ عَشَرَ. And three camels, ثَلَاثَ شِيَاتٍ. Three camels. وَفِي الْعِشْرِينَ. And when it reaches 20, four sheeps. وَإِلَى خَمْسَ وَعِشْرِينَ فَفِيهَا بِنْتُ مَخَاد. And once it reaches 25, bintu makhad, a sheep or a camel which is bintu makhad, which means a camel which is a year old. And it's called bintu makhad because al makhad is a camel which is pregnant. So usually after the camel, jayid, has reached the age of one, its mother's become what again? Pregnant again. So it's called bintu makhad, a female camel of a pregnant camel. Yes, because a camel is pregnant, is pregnant. So a year old, that's the year. But it's called bintu makhad when it reaches 25. And then he went on to say, وَهِيَ بِنْتُ سَنَى فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ عِنْدَهُ فَابْنُ لَبُونَ. And if he doesn't have bintu makhad, Jayid, if he doesn't have a camel which is a year old, bintu labun, a two-year-old camel. And it's called bintu labun because by that time, a two-year-old camel, its mother has delivered and his mother, had another child. And what is it doing to the other child? Milking it. So the camel of a mother who is milking. So this is bintu labun. إِلَى سِتَّ وَثَلَاثِينَ. So from 25 all the way to what? 36. Jayid, once it reaches 36, فَيَجُبُ فِيهَا بِنْتْ لَبُونَ. That's the age you give a zakah, bintu labun, a two-year-old camel. A two-year-old what? Camel. So between 25 all the way to 35, this is the range. And what is the range called? Waqs. Jayid? So even though there's an increase, does the zakah increase between 25 to 35? No. It starts to increase when it reaches what? 30? 36. Tayyib. And then he says, إِلَى سِتْ وَأَرْبَعِينَ فَيَجِبُ فِيهَا حِقَّةً. When it reaches 46, the next range is what? 46. Once it reaches 46, you give حِقَّة. Try to memorize. The first one is مَخَاد, 1 year old. The second one is what? Bintu Labun, 2 years old. And the third one is Hiqqa. Hiqqa, 3 years old. It's called Hiqqa because yastahiqqu an yuhmal alayha. Because it has the right for you to carry upon it, to use for transportation. Warrukub, and for you to use for traveling. For you to carry goods, so yastahiqqu, there's a haq now. Because once you reach 3 years old, the camel, you could use it for transportation and for carrying goods. It's called hiqqa. So up to 46, hiqqa. And it's 3 years old. وَإِلَى إِحْدَى وَسِتِّينَ فَيَجِبُ فِيهَا جَذَعَةٌ. And once it reaches 61, you give جَذَعَةٌ. This is the oldest age you could give, which is 4 years old. 4 years old camel. وَإِلَى سِتَّ أَرْبَعِينَ. So up to 46, what do you give? 4 years old. 46? What number did you just mention now? وَإِلَى سِتَّ أَرْبَعِينَ. أيوه, 61. وَاحِدْ وَسِتِّينَ. وَإِلَى سِتَّ وَسَبِعِينَ. And up to 76, فَفِيهَا إِبْنَتَا لَبُونَ. Up to 76, you give two bintu labun. And what is bintu labun? 2 years old. So you give two two-year-old camel of a mother who is what? Milking. Two two-year-old. When is 76? وَلَا إِحْدَى وَتِسْعِينَ. And when is 91, you give two hiqqa. And what is hiqqa? Two three-year-old camel. Jayid? Subhanallah. We don't know the wisdom behind this. وَلَكِنْ سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. هَذَا مِنَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. And these rulings of these numbers is found in Al-Bukhari, in the book of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, which he wrote to Anas radiallahu an. These figures are found in the Kitab Abu Bakr, the letter of Bakr to Anas when he was in Bahrain. And Bahrain in those days is what we know today as Ahsa, which is in Saudi Arabia. Jayid, Bahrain. So up to 91, Hiqqatan. Yes, 2 3-year-olds. Yes. Wa ila 20. And up to 20 wa mi'a, up to 120, it remains so. Up to 120, two hiqqa. And anything after 120, meaning 121, thalatha banat labun, three labun. And what is a labun? Two-year-old. You get it? Anything above 121, how many three-year-olds? Three. Thumma fi kulli khamsin hiqqa. After that, now you start to calculate. After 121, for every 50, hiqqa. And nowadays a hiqqa? Three-year-old. So for every 50 after 121, one hiqqa. Jayid? Wa fi kulli arba'een, and for every, and the reason this is important, it helps you to calculate is, and in every arba'een, in every single 40 is not a hiqqa, but rather how many do you have? Bint labun. One bintu labun. For every 40, a 2-year-old. For every 50, a 3-year-old. Which is hiqqa. Jayid? We should have a diagram here actually. It would have been helpful. Jayid? For either zadat. Until 200. Until 200. Yes, فَيَجْتَمِعْ فِيهَا فَرْضًا. And two numbers come at 200. Or two types of obligation comes at 200. So if you have 200 camels, فَإِنْ شَاءَ أَخْرَجَ أَرْبَعًا. If he has 200 camels, he could give how many now? He could give أَرْبَعًا حِقَاق. He could give 4 3-year-old. Or 5 2-year-old. بَارَكَ فِيكَ. MashaAllah, the math is on point. So I'll ask some questions since the math is on point. So now, Abu Salman here, he has a number of camels, Allahumma barik. Abu Salman, for example, has 130 camels. What is the zakat that's due upon him from 130 camels? Because you go now in tens. Because after 121, you go in 10s. He has 130 camels. What is the zakat due upon you, Abu Salman? We said, for every 50, hiqqa. And for every 40, labun. So now you have 130 camels. Barakallahu fi. Two hiqqa and one labun. You sure? Sahih. Two hiqqa is how many? 50. So you got 100. You done 100. Jayid? And how many have you got left? You got 30 left. But bintu labuns for every 40. Can someone else calculate it? We say hiqqa. One hiqqa, which is what? 3-year-old. So 50 is gone. Out of, if you take 50 from 130, how much is left? 80. So what's remaining? 2 bintu labun. You get it? So 50, one hiqqa, 50. And you're left with 80 tun to bint labun. So you've done 130. Sheikh Sa'id, mashallah ta'ala. And you should know this, because Asluka, your roots, where you come from, mashallah, they have a lot of camels there. Even in Nigeria, we have many camels, believe it or not. In fact, Sheikh Suleiman will tell you here, my surname is Rifa'i Onirakumi. Onirakumi means the camel herders. My grandfather was a Fulani. He said he was the first person to bring camels into Nigeria. So our surname is the camel herders. Yes? So Saeed, you have 140 camels. What? 140. I'll give you an easy one actually. 140 camels. Barakallah fi. Hiqqatan, two hiqqa and one bintu labun. Very easy. Tayyib, let me give, who's Sheikhuna Suleiman? He came late. I know. Sheikh Shuja'. You have 150 camels. MashaAllah. Alatu. Three hiqqa. Okay. Akhuna, you have 160. Another easy one. 160. Barakallah. 4 times 4, 16. 40 times 4, 160. Because it will be how many now? 4 bintu labun. Jayed. Akhi, you have 4 bintu labun. Because bintu labun, for every 40, bintu labun. Jayed, you have 170. Barakallah fiqh. Yes, 150, which is hiqqa, and 3 bintu labun. Very good, mashallah. So now you have 180. MashaAllah. Very good. Hiqqatan wa binta al-labun. Yes. 2 hiqqa and 2 bintu labun. 2 2-year-olds and 2 3-year-olds. Abu Salman, 190 camels. Barakallah fiqh. 3 hiqqaq and 1 bintu labun. Jayid? Very good. Until 200. He said, ila mi'atain. Once you reach 200, you have choices. Either 4 or 5. Jayid. And then Mu'allif, rahimullahu ta'ala, this issue now, which is going to mention, is specific to issue of camels. He says, regarding the camels, and this is specific to camels only, that concerning these number, that whoever does not find this specific amount, فَمَنْ وَجَبَتْ عَلَيْهِ سِنٌّ فَلَمْ يَجِدْهَا أَخْرَجَ أَدْنَى مِنْهَا وَمَعَهَا شَاتَانَ أَوْ عِشْرُونَ دِرْهَمًا. Whoever is obligatory upon him to give a specific age, and he could not find that specific age, he could give something less and pay 20 dirhaman. So for example, if it's obligatory upon you now, bint a labun. How old is bint a labun? 2 years old. If you cannot find bint labun, you could pay with bintu makhad. How old is bintu makhad? 1 year old. And you pay along with it 20 dirham. Because the price in those days of this was what? Of a sheep is 10 dirham. So you could pay with it 20 dirham or 2 sheeps. Jayed? Or you could pay 10 dirham and 1 sheep. Jayed? So you could give the equivalent of 2 sheeps or 1 sheep and 10 dirham. But 10 dirham, that was in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the price of a sheep. 10 dirham, I don't think you buy a quarter, even a tenth of a sheep. So you have to basically pay the equivalent. Whoever doesn't find bintu, for example, labun could pay bintu makhad. And then the author goes on to say, but this is only specific to what? To camels. That, and whoever doesn't find his equivalent could pay with something which is less. Oh, wa in sha'a akhraja a'la minha wa akhada shatain. أو 20 dirham, or you could pay with something which is more, with something which is more, and then you could take for something which is more 20 dirham or 2 sheeps. What do we mean by this? For example, it's a problem you now to pay bintu makhad, which is 1 year old, but you don't have bintu makhad, you don't have any 1 year old from a camel which is what, who's pregnant. We have bintu labun. So what do you do now? You pay with bintu labun and you take back 20 dirham, the equivalent of the price of 2 sheep, or you could take back 2 sheep. How do you take back 2 sheep? Because in those days, the zakat was distributed. So the person is collected some sheep from this person, so he exchanged with you. You understand? And if he cannot exchange with you, with sheep, it will give you what? Money. So there's change, subhanAllah, because of justice. You pay something more, but you get your money back. So even if you're paying more, you still get your what back? Your change back, subhanAllah. So it's a haqq wal wajib. SubhanAllah. Allah Ta'ala, a'dalul adilin. The most just of those who are just. SubhanAllah. So you pay with this. Jayyid? So on this issue, this is called jubran. This issue of the camel where you pay with something less or something more. It's only specific to what? Camels. The next is upon al-baqar, on the cows. Inshallah Ta'ala, next we're going to that. And the week after that, we're going to go into athman, which is valuables, gold and silver, or it's equivalent in terms of currencies. And one of the things that will come up, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, are contemporary issues like stocks and shares. You know, and this is very, very important, you know, that the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it comes to contemporary issues, yes, or what they call, what's another word for contemporary? New affairs, things that have happened newly. It deals with all of these issues, subhanAllah. مَا فَرَطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. We've not left anything out of the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, as Allah Ta'ala says. So these contemporary issues, it deals with everything. You know, so if you go to Awqaf, for example, you find books on the most contemporary issue, be it plastic surgery, be it mental illness. And one of the books I found recently about mental illness surprised me greatly, because many people, when it comes to mental illness, because it's not something necessarily physical, they automatically associate with what? With jinn and sihr. La. Mental illness in itself is something, what? Physical. Ajib. You know, so when it comes to the issue of stocks and shares, it goes into all of these issues. That deen of Allah Ta'ala, kulli makani wa zaman, for all times and all places. So when it comes to athman, gold and silver, and its equivalent in terms of currency, it's a very, very important class. And last week, one of the things that confused the people was the issue of properties we mentioned. We said properties you live in, there's no zakat upon it. But if it's been advertised or you bought it to sell your property, what do you call it again? If property investor, then it's for the zakat. But if you buy a property to rent, the zakat is upon the rent, not upon the initial money you bought the property for. Jayyid? Any questions, inshallah?